Oh, you're recording.
No, not at all.
Not at all. Shit, I look like I'm working on something. So I just sit here and feel inspired.
Yeah,
it just comes sit. To me.
Okay, so today we are in the lair of one artist, Anna Jano, and so I wanted to give you a little bit of behind the scenes of who this creature is and what she produces, and just to show that not all martial artists, and as well, you know, the martial arts is all they ever do. All they think about, they do nothing else in their life. They have no other talents or hobbies or whatever else. The process of Core JKD is a creative process. And I demand that of my instructors who work under me, and any of the students that work under me as well, is, or alongside me, is that they are immersed in the creative process. And so she's actually like a serious artist. She's like one of these real ones. So making herself known in various places and putting herself out there. So we're gonna look over at some of the stuff she's doing today. We're gonna have her perform. We didn't get the little tin bells.
We'll make do.
But we'll make do. Okay. So I'll depart and you can watch her.
So this pile is all of the miscellaneous artwork I've done over probably the last 2 years. And I don't have a flat file, I just kind of throw it in here. And it's everything from like finished ink pieces to just random doodles. Yeah, so we'll go in the way back here. And I worked on a wedding invitation for my brother and sister-in-law, and this was part of their invitation. I did some decorative Art Nouveau type of work, which was kind of fun. Oh, here's a cool one. I didn't even know I had it. So if anybody's been following me, you know I did this giant deer piece. When was that? The end of last year. And I guess this is the original sketch. And if you go look at that piece, you can see I got rid of all these circles later. But the heart of it is there. This is all still there, so that's cool. I see more random doodles. I enjoy these geometric abstracts. So when I'll usually sit down and I won't know what it's gonna be. I'll just start with a circle or something and then see where it goes and where it feels right. And this one's pretty cool. I might have to scan it and do something with it, but yeah. Every year I do this challenge online called Inktober, where you draw a single ink drawing every day for each day in October. And last year I did an entire story, 31 page story, and they ended up being this size. This was one of the mid of the month pieces in that. I had started out doing these giant ones. This was the first one in that series. And this one took me probably 4 or 5 hours, and by like the sixth day, I realized I could not keep that up for all month, so I went a little smaller, so they didn't have to be as detailed. And it worked out. It actually made me figure out some cool solutions to be faster.
So, like this piece that you've got before you, exactly what's your process? What do you do?
Well, this is an Inktober piece, and for this year in Inktober, I wanted to do longer form ink pieces, because in the past, I would just knock out a piece in a single day, and it would be rushed, and they would be cool, but there's not as much detail in those as I would like to start getting into. So I wanted to really get a good composition and to just make a nice detailed piece. So I started out with thumbnails, which I do a lot on the iPad now. So this is Procreate on the iPad, which is the application I use on the iPad, and I have a Apple Pencil that I use. And for a larger piece like this, I like to plan at the same aspect ratio. So I have these little squares, what the general composition is going to be. And this one I got really nitpicky on. I started out here and made little small changes throughout where I wanted the skulls to be, where how the feet on the house came off. Oops. Yeah, it's a little small minutia, how the legs are. And then I also, on this one, did some value studies, as in, where are the darkest parts of the... I did some value studies, as in, like, where are the darkest parts of the piece going to be? And we can see the final result from all that scribble. All that information was in there in my head, and then I just had to get it onto the paper. And this took me about, I don't remember, like 4 or 5 days to ink all the layers of it, and I'm pretty happy with the results. So I'm gonna start the next one tomorrow. I'm in the middle of Inktober right now, so this year I was gonna do a small piece or a large piece every day and show the progress of it every day. The mythology behind this one is the Baba Yaga, who I've been really into lately. It's a Russian fairy tale about this old lady that lives in the woods and eats kids. So it's really wholesome.
And, right up your alley.
Right up my alley. But she, her house, in the mythology, her house is on chicken legs, which is like the most weird thing in the world. And it can get up and walk around. And then she has the skulls and bones of the kids around the house, just, you know, for decoration. and then she flies in. She flies in this mortar and pestle contraption. So it's just the weirdest mythology I've come across, and I'm totally into it.
Okay, so we have the rain bearing down on us, but she has her ink water. She's going to tell us a little bit
about it. Well, because for whatever reason, if I'm really into a subject, I don't spend any money on it. Same with training. I have the same boxing gloves I've had for like 6 years. They're falling apart. So I'm an inker, right? I need an inkwell. So what do? I use an old eraser and a wire nut, stick it in here. And I put my ink in here, and for 2 years I would ruin brushes by sticking it in here.
Oh, wow.
So for this Inktober, I decided to splurge on myself and spend $12 to get an inkwell. It was a cool, really like vintage inkwell I found on Etsy that I'm really happy to have now. So now I'm a professional artist with a professional inkwell. So maybe I'll go buy some boxing gloves now and treat myself. So,
very
yes.
Cool, very cool. We're going to close out here, but that gives you a little bit of insight. Let us know whether you like that or not, and certainly comment. And check out her work. She's got Instagram, she's got other, we'll put links also in the description, but she also has...
AnnaJano.com. I have my portfolio and web store on there. And then I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at all the same handle, Anna Jano Art. And we'll put those links somewhere.
Definitely. Anyway, that's the cool stuff that's lurking in the people that happen to train with you. Get to know them. Take a look around you and see who's there. And look inside yourself, because that stuff that's in there, you know, you're going to find a lot of people who want to see that. So be bold, you know, put it out there. You know, we're forcing it upon her here in this venue, but it's been a long crawling time to get her out to do it in a larger scale like this. And I'm still working on getting her on her own YouTube channel. So, you know, that's to come. So we'll see how that works. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. Ming is gone. For the full 18-minute interview, where we plunder through her stash of hidden work, including revealing one of my favorite pieces, check out our Patreon site. The full interview should be up there later today. Thank you for watching.